tiny bit of a shield.
This is Sorry. Big Brother. Molly. Jerry comes to
die. I got.
Jerry, please could you give the name of your first nomination and explain your reasons for this nomination?
The first name has to be Charlie. Charlie has got away with murder so far. He hasn't been up for eviction for a long time, for, you know, 6 weeks now. And I think it's unacceptable because he has had a fight with the vast majority of the people in this house. I even found myself dragged into a huge fight with her that was so out of character. So she managed to turn a very, very calm person into close to be a beast. You know, I didn't recognize myself. So for that, that's the first thing. The second thing is I'm practically bored of her continuous name-dropping and description of a lifestyle that I find rather shallow.
Now could you give the name of your second nomination and explain your reasons for this nomination?
Nikki. She has an ability to manipulate people into situations. I don't think that ability is that successful. I just don't trust her. She listens behind closed doors. I've caught her in the act. I think she will do anything to stay in the house for a couple of more weeks, which is completely meaningless. Plus, he's got this grumpy attitude most of the time. You know, she hardly ever smiles. She externalizes her anger, and you know, it's like when you're around her, you have to walk on eggshells. I love this expression, but you know, you have to be careful. She's very grumpy.
I'm in kind of music and stuff like that.
Right.
Yeah. Just I mess around
with
music.
Like.
I used to be in a band years ago.
Oh, right.
And just as like a.
What
group
kind of band?
Kind of. Like a pop.
Were you successful?
They're right, not so successful. But we did okay.
What were you called?
We called Northern Line.
Northern Line.
Yeah, it was like an English group. But tell me about yourself anyway. Because
I'm here
named to learn
after
about you.
The Northern Line.
Yeah, I know. How
I'm just a waitress. Yeah, you're not just
like, a waitress.
I am just a waitress. I just like.
Yeah.
I wait tables. It's not very exciting.
Yeah, no, that's cool. I've been a waiter. I was a waiter when the band finished.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Sporty. You fitness, yeah.
Oh. Not loads. Right. I used to do some dance classes, yeah. And I did a bit of cheerleading.
Cool. But, yeah.
I want to know more about your band. That sounds
fun.
No,
it's a long time ago.
When was it?
I'm sure we have loads of time anyway.
When was it?
I mean, it was ages ago.
Next to the diary room is Liam.
First nomination is Nikki. I think she's a little bit spiteful, a little bit vindictive. She's often jealous of people's friendships and things and tries to make out the reasoning behind why they're friends as if everything's a game to her and that everybody's the bad person and she's, you know, just misunderstood. If people are getting along well and having a good time, she wants to put a stop to it because she sees any fun having in this house is a reflection on her personality or lack of personality. My second nomination is Charlie. The reason being is she's argumentative. Plus, I think, you know, she's quite clicky with Nikki. Didn't mean to rhyme there. And they're often quite bitchy in that, you know, she plays people against each other. She's very clever, lass. But she's a boiling pot and, you know, I don't want to live with somebody as explosive.
So far, Nikki has 5 nominations, Charlie has 3, Carol and Tracy have 2, Jerry and Chanel have 1 nomination each. 5:55 p.m. Jerry and fake Australian housemate Pauline are on the sofas.
So do you have Italian grandparents?
Yeah, on my mum's side.
Your grandma was called Simonetta.
No, my grandma was called Pauline.
Pauline?
She's not Pauline. Italian.
Oh, she's
my granddad is Italian. That's why I'm called Pauline.
Pauline?
But I don't like the
In
name.
In Greek is Paulina.
I mean, I'm sorry, Ned.
You don't like Paulina?
No, I don't Paulina? Like Pauline. Oh, I don't know. I just think, like, that's why everyone calls me Pooh. I know that
the most famous
the
Pauline
the
is the sister of Napoleon. She was called Pauline Bonaparte. So she's a slut.
Housemates have been nominating for 2 hours and 32 minutes. Nicky nominated Jerry and Ziggy. Sam has just nominated Carol and Charlie. Tracy is next to nominate.
My first nomination this week is Ziggy again. I'm finding him very two-faced at the minute. He split up with Chanel. He's trying to get around everybody to be his mate, especially with the lads, and he's been doing exactly the same with some of the girls. He's very idle, doesn't do nothing apart from eat. And it's just not the sort of person I get on with, really. My second nomination this week is pretty bleeding Jerry, man. How idle is that geezer, you know? And he's another one, he's becoming very two-faced in this house. Before they split up, when Zig and Chanel had a to-do in the bedroom, he was quick to, got his arm round her and that. And he was, you know, quick to down Charlie. And like, well, you got the right to go and speak to her like that for? I don't know, half an hour later, he's all like, you know, he was mate with Charlie. And he's arse-licking around Carol because she's quite a big character in this house. And he's proper mummy's boy, man. And we're just not hitting it off. I haven't spoken to that bloke hardly in the last 2 days. He's so two-faced and so up people's arses. It's unbelievable.
La 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 la. Gravy. Everyone's going in the pearl.
The last housemate to nominate is Ziggy.
Ziggy.
Yes.
Please could you give the name of your first nomination and explain your reasons for this nomination?
My first nominations this week will be Nicky, because we just don't get along. She's a mixer. I believe that she's behind a lot of stuff that's gone on in the house. You know, as soon as myself and Chanel decided to call it a day, she was straight up to Chanel, making out she cared when, you know, myself and Chanel clearly know that she doesn't care. Because, basically, she was the one who, through the grapevine, was the one who kind of planned the whole nomination thing with Chanel the week before, and you know, she ignored her for a week, and pretty much ignored me for a week, and then obviously when found out that she was still in the house, you know, suddenly was straight over there going, you know, I'm so excited you're still in the house, you know, it means so much to me. That's what I call a mixer.
Now could you give the name of your second nomination and explain your reasons for this nomination?
I'm going to choose Charlie as my second nomination. I just find that she plays a lot of games and, you know, and plays games with people and tries to play games with people's heads and, you know, maybe that's what she's here for. But I just don't trust her. It's been a difficult decision because I've found myself kind of growing closer towards her. You know, she's a pain in the arse, she really is, but she's got some funny sides to her. But in back of my head, do I really want this person out? Yes, I do, but she brings, you know, some funny stuff to this house. So, I mean, that's what I mean by a hard decision.
As Nicky received 6 nominations and Charlie received 5, they'll both face a public vote for the fake eviction later this week. Carol and Jerry received 3 nominations. Tracy and Ziggy received 2. Chanel received 1 nomination. Brian, Liam, Sam and Amanda received no nominations. 6:36 p.m. Actress Tyler is in her private area. Carol and Ziggy are on the sofas talking about Pauline.
Yeah. I know she's not in the main house yet. And I find it surprising that they're going to do this thing with the public and then nominations as well.
Well, basically her job over here is kind of probably to get it on with someone.
So I'm sceptical.
Do you not agree with that? Otherwise there's no point in just having an extra house.
Well, what are they going to do with Laura in Australia then?
Huh?
What are they going to do with Laura in Australia?
Well, that's it. I don't know. But I think that's, if someone's here for a week, they have to do something pretty spectacular. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, so if she does have a game plan, she may have a game plan. That's what they've done. But I don't think that would be the game plan.
Amanda and Jerry are in the garden.
Look, it will turn to butterfly.
Can you see it?